Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to be talking to you about a really sensitive issue to me, and that is my weight. It's something I've been dealing with my entire life. As a kid, I was always called Chantelle Belly, and it really bothered me. My body's built differently than a lot of people's, and also I'm just never really been a skinny girl. And it's just something that's always been kind of eating away at me. And just recently I've learned that even though I might not look super perfect, I can still have a really healthy and happy life. First I'm going to be showing you guys a couple of pictures from when I was growing up, just to show kind of like the struggle I've been going through my entire life. So here's just a couple of pictures of my sister and I. And it's me on this side, and it's just something, like, you can just tell by my face, I wasn't the skinniest kid in the world. Another one is, this is in grade 5, and again, it's the same situation kind of thing. And then the last one is, I would have been in about grade 6 or 7 in this picture. And it's just something I've always been dealing with. I, as a kid, had somewhat of a healthy sports kind of childhood. I was definitely more into the arts, but I still swam my entire childhood, and I was in dance. So between competitive swimming and then Irish and Ukrainian dance, I was quite active. I also curled for a while, and I just did a little bit of a couple different sports throughout the years, but those were the main ones. My mom is diabetic, so we always ate healthy in our household. Half your plate always had to be vegetables, and I was still dealing with weight issues, and it really was hard to watch people in my class that were sticks eat like Ichiban noodles and pop for lunch, and I was sitting there eating my broccoli and carrot sticks and a sandwich and still was gaining weight as they were perfect. I didn't really understand the whole metabolism thing at that age, but it was just really hard to be known as the big girl in the class. I've never really been massive, but at the same time I've never really been that small average girl, and it took a long time and a lot of names and a lot of people tearing me down to finally realize it's okay. I'm a healthy person between all those sports, and then I was a summer camp leader for the past 5 years. I can still run with the kids, I can still play, and I have a lot of fun doing things like that. But it's just, I'm just never going to look perfect. And that's been something really hard to deal with. I like when I go out to go get my pasta and stuff like that, but I know that there has to be balance, and when you go and get pasta, you can't go home and eat a tray of cookies, no matter how bad you feel about yourself, because that's something that I do a lot. I am a stress eater, so when I get really stressed with school or life, or people would tear me down at school about my weight, I would go home and I'd grab the entire bag of chocolate chips and just hide them. I would hide food, like, I didn't want my mom to know that I was stress eating, so I'd hide food in my drawers, I would quickly eat it, and then when she would ask where it went, I'd be like, I don't know, I'm not sure. I just was in a really bad depressed state because of my weight. And it's something that it took years, it took a lot of getting torn down to realize that it's okay. My biggest thing that I would definitely recommend to anyone that is dealing with weight issues is that what really matters is that you're healthy. If you don't like the way you look, you can try to lose weight. Do not do any crash diets. It's just not good for you. You'll end up getting sick, and as soon as you start eating again, it will just all get packed back onto you. So I definitely suggest this: eating right and exercise are the two best things. And I know you've probably heard about it a million times, but it truly is the most important that you're healthy versus being a stick. My body's built that I can't be a stick no matter how hard I try. I do have pudge, but yeah. Some of the biggest struggles that I find because of my weight are when you go out for lunch or shopping with your friends, I order like a salad and stuff like that, and they're getting burgers and pizza and just all this stuff that I am somewhat jealous that I don't get to eat all that stuff, but in the end, I'm still happy with myself, and it's hard sometimes though. when you go into stores and your friends are complaining because there's not extra small sizes left on the rack, and you're complaining because there's not an extra large. It makes you feel terrible about yourself, but at the same time, you have to realize to dress for your body and not try to dress for your friend's body. Everyone is beautiful in their own ways, and I might not be beautiful stick figure, but I think I have a beautiful personality, and that I am a fairly positive person and can bring that to my life. And it's, nobody can be perfect in all aspects, that at least if you're happy with yourself, that's what truly matters. I don't really have too much more to say other than I understand what you're going through. It's just something that, sadly, I've had to go through. I wish that people hadn't bullied me because of it and called me Chantelle Belly all the time, because that's really hurtful to me. But at the same time, I kind of say thank you because you helped me grow as a person. And now I just kind of laugh off those comments. If somebody calls me something bad, I don't take it personally anymore. Take it as that old like adage kind of thing, like people tear you down if they're being torn down themselves. So just kind of like smiling off, kill them with kindness kind of thing is like one of my favorite things. So I have a few more pictures, if I could grab behind the camera, of me in some of my heavier ages. This is at my dad's wedding. That's me and my little sister. And yeah, it's just me and my braces. I was bigger girl, like always, but I was still quite happy. And then one more I have is, one of the hardest things for me is when my sister gets to go bikini shopping, and I'm scared to even wear a one piece on the beach because I feel like people are staring at me. And you see all these perfect people all around you in these bikinis, and I'm out there in shorts and a t-shirt because I, not to cover it up per se, but I don't want to draw attention to myself. So this is a picture of us in Mexico. We went for like a through the forest hike kind of thing, my sister and I, and she's wearing these tight clothes and it looks so good on her, and then I'm wearing a t-shirt and some yoga pants. And it was really warm out. I just felt like I needed to be covered up because people didn't want to see that. And really, in the end, are they going to remember that girl on the beach that wore t-shirts and shorts or a one-piece bathing suit because she wanted to go out and get a tan? Or will they remember your personality? If they're going to remember anything, it's most likely going to be your amazing personality. If you put yourself out there, it doesn't matter what you look like, as long as you are willing to be positive and live a happy life. The main thing is, if you're happy, you'll attract more happy people. It doesn't matter what you look like. I have friends that are bigger than me. I have friends that are sticks, but yet we have so much in common that it doesn't matter what we look like. It just matters that we're friends, that we'll always be there for each other, and that's pretty much all that matters. So this is kind of a long kind of like, it doesn't really make sense, this video, I guess. It's just kind of me talking about an issue that's been part of my life, my entire life. And I just thought I'd share with you guys because I know I'm not the only person that's probably dealing with these issues. I have become very depressed in the past because of these issues, and I will do anything if I can help at least one person not go through that. So if you are going through that, I'm here for you. If you wanted to send me an inbox message, I'll be that person to listen and hear about your issues. And no matter what your issues are, if they're weight related, if they're just stress, whatever, if you need someone to talk to, I will be that person if you need it. That's that confidential person, just someone to give you advice. I'm here for you if you need it. But anyways, I know that was kind of like not the happiest video of all times, and I'm sorry about that, but it's an issue that I really think needed to be talked about, because it's not okay when you look in the mirror and you see the words that everyone else has said about you, about your weight, about what you do, about everything in your life, and you see that instead of the beautiful person in front of you with the great attributes that you bring to society. Like, it's just, it's terrible that people see that instead of who they really are and the beautiful person they are. So I'll talk to you guys later. Yeah, bye! Everybody makes mistakes. Everybody has those days. I wear my sunglasses at night. Although it's not night. So I wear my sunglasses at day. Look, I hit my arm.
But I decorated it.
See? Whoa! Not decorated. Decorated! Oh, I'm awkwardly gonna wear my sunglasses inside. Cause I can. Whoa, 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 oh, oh. Whoa, oh, oh, oh. I don't know what to do. La 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 dee dee doo. My hair is all coming out.
I'm a fish.
Take you for a ride on my big green tractor. We can go slow or make it go faster. Out through the woods and out to the pasture. As long as I'm with you, it really don't matter. The day you told me you love me.
Can't make a heart.
Shakira, Shakira. You're the bird. Whenever we pretend it's summer, then I'm the worm. Know the part, it's such a bummer, but fair, it's fair. So just remember, if you guys need anything, I am here to listen. I hope you guys really have a really, really great day. That's as awesome as you are, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.